Hello everyone, and welcome to the CSS Security Mini Briefing, where we will present a short summary of what was released today, February 14th, 2023. My name is Josh Daniel, and I'm a risk manager in the customer service and support organization here at Microsoft. We're going to start this video with an overview of the release, and then we'll dive into a few of the vulnerabilities from today. Please note that the details of the vulnerabilities we are covering in this video may change, and the authoritative location for information will always be the online content in the security update guide. So before I dive into the vulnerabilities from today's release, I like to compare this release to the previous 12 months, so we get a full 13-month average on some of these things. And as far as the number of vulnerabilities, we've been averaging almost 79 vulnerabilities per month. This month, there are 77 new vulnerabilities from today's release, so just a shade under our average. Next, I'll talk about remote code execution vulnerabilities. These are the ones that typically, from an impact perspective, they would have the most risk. It would allow a threat actor to install software and other similar tasks. We've been averaging almost 27 per month. And this month we have 37 total remote code execution vulnerabilities, so a little bit above average. Next, I'll talk about critical vulnerabilities. Critical is a severity rating that's proprietary to Microsoft. There's three different severity ratings. There's moderate, and then important, and then critical. This month there are 9 total vulnerabilities that hit that critical severity, and that's a little bit above our average, around 7.5. Next, I'll talk about CVSS scores. Microsoft uses an industry standard scoring system called the Common Vulnerability Scoring System, or CVSS. This is a scale between 1 and 10 that helps software vendors and compare some of these vulnerabilities with each other across products, across vendors, and gives that nice baseline to be able to compare different vulnerabilities to each other. It's comprised of a set of metrics such as attack vector, attack complexity, privileges required, user interaction, and a few others. It does not include things like severity rating or impact, or whether vulnerability has been known to be exploited out in the wild, or whether it's previously disclosed, and other things like that. But what it does is it allows vendors to be able to compare these different vulnerabilities and get a general idea of the type of risk. This month, the highest rated CVSS score is 9.8 on that scale of 10. And we've been averaging right around 9.35 over the past 13 months. The average score across all 77 vulnerabilities is 7.62, which is about a quarter point higher than our average of around 7.3. There are no publicly disclosed vulnerabilities in the set this month. We've been averaging right around 1.25. And finally, when we look at vulnerabilities known to be exploited out in the wild, there are 3 in today's set, and that's quite a bit higher in relative terms of our average of just over 1. So let's take a look at today's release. Those of you that are familiar with this slide, you'll recognize where we put the Windows products on the bottom part of the slide, and then some of the products that are not serviced regularly up on the top part. This month is no different. Windows products, depending on the specific product, we're averaging right around in the mid-30s. And that's right around average for some of the older products. Some of the newer products like Windows 11 and Server 22, they've been averaging closer in the mid-40s, so a little bit lower on the overall numbers for those new ones. As we move up the chart, we see Microsoft Office making appearance, as it usually does, with 5 vulnerabilities. Microsoft Exchange Server has a handful of remote code execution vulnerabilities this month. .NET Framework, Visual Studio, Dynamics 365, SQL Server all have a handful of vulnerabilities. And then rounding out the set, we have Power BI Report Server, Azure DevOps, .NET 6 and .NET 7, and Microsoft Defender for Endpoint. So let's jump into the first vulnerability from today's set that we'll cover in this video. This is CVE-2023-21689. And this is a vulnerability in the Microsoft Protected Extensible Authentication Protocol. This was privately disclosed to Microsoft with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a severity rating of critical. The base CVSS score on this vulnerability is 9.8 on that scale of 10. So really close to being the top score possible. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. Privileges required is none, and user interaction here is also none. There are a couple mitigations here that I'll talk about, or one mitigation rather, and that's that the protected extensible authentication protocol is only negotiated with the client if MPS is running on the Windows server and has a network policy configured that allows PEEP. To stop this, customers can ensure that the PEEP type is not configured as an allowed EAP type, extensible authentication protocol, in their network policy. And there's a couple links in the CVE article that provide a little bit more information on the mitigation tier. As far as the affected software, it's all versions of Windows that are in support. On the desktop side, it's Windows 10 and Windows 11. And on the server side, it's 2012 up through the latest Server 2022. Next, I'll talk about CVE 2023-21803. This is a critical remote code execution vulnerability in the iSCSI discovery service. This was privately disclosed to Microsoft with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a base score of 9.8 on a scale of 10. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. Privileges required here is none, and user interaction here is also none. This one does have a couple mitigations. Specifically, the first one is that the iSCSI initiator client application is disabled by default. So in order to exploit this, that iSCSI initiator has to be enabled. And that does take some extra work and extra steps there. I'll also point out another mitigation here is that it's only the 32-bit based versions of Windows are affected here. So the x64 is not affected by this vulnerability. And it only is applicable to Windows 10. And so it's very specific on what needs to occur here for a threat actor to be able to take advantage of this. There are no documented mitigations for this vulnerability. And the third vulnerability that we'll cover today is CVE 2023-21716. This is a critical remote code execution vulnerability in Microsoft Word. This was privately disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a base score of 9.8. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. Privileges required is none, and user interaction here is also none. There's no documented mitigations for this vulnerability, but there are a couple published workarounds here, specifically on how to prevent Office from opening RTF documents. So if you're curious, please take a look at the CVE article where there's links on that guidance on how to prevent Word from loading those RTF files. As far as the affected software, it's a large list, as we can see. I won't go into each individual product, but please take a look there. It's not just the Word standalone application that's affected here. It's also applications that leverage Word in one way or another, such as SharePoint. So please take a look at that list of affected software if you have any questions on whether or not your product is affected. And also, I would encourage you to take a look at the CVE article. Another thing I'll point out about this is that the preview pane is an attack vector for this vulnerability. A lot of times with Office vulnerabilities, if you get an email and there's a document attached, you're able to view that document in the preview pane without being affected by the vulnerability. That's not the case here. So if you were to receive this email with a document that's been created to take advantage of this vulnerability and you open it up in the preview pane, you are then potentially vulnerable to this vulnerability. And one key point about that is it's typically in the Office realm. If the preview pane is affected, that will give it the critical severity as opposed to important. And so that's the case here, critical severity, and the preview pane is affected for this. All right, that's it for today's video. I want to thank everyone for taking time to listen to me talk about some vulnerabilities, and I will talk to you all next month. Thank you.